News at 9. Brought to you by Vicco, trusted Ayurveda since 1952.
Namaskar and welcome. I am Tarth Sekhar. In the next few minutes, we'll be getting the top news of the last 24 hours. On April 6, another setback to Congress former Defence Minister AK Antony's son Anil Antony joined Bharatiya Janata Party in Delhi. Anil Antony joined the BJP in the presence of Union Minister Piyush Goyal and V. Muralidharan. Kerala BJP Chief K. Sundaran and senior party leaders Tarun Chugh and Anil Baluni were also present at the occasion. Anil Antony thanked Prime Minister Narendra Modi for his induction into the party. Delhi High Court pulls up Arvind Kejriwal, led Delhi government over non-payment of funds and non-issuance of work order even after 2 years of successful completion of Sardar Patel COVID care center offering 10,000 beds. The court said it is very sorry state of affairs. On April 6, Tamil Nadu BJP Chief K. Annamalai painted the party's lotus symbol on a wall near the party office in the T. Nagar area in the city on the occasion of BJP's 44th Foundation Day. K. Annamalai said that in this not so distant future, BJP will also come to power in Tamil Nadu. We want to make sure that PM's and our national president's vision get translated on the ground. BJP should strengthen itself and come to power in the state by 2026. This is our vision and mission. President Draupadi Murmu arrived on a 3-day visit to Assam. On April 6, the president will inaugurate a 2-day Hasti Mahotsav or Gaj festival at the park on April 7 morning before leaving for Guwahati. The center and the state government jointly organized the annual elephant festival to conserve the Asiatic elephant and find ways to resolve increasing human-elephant conflict. It should be mentioned that the annual elephant festival attracts a number of Indian and foreign tourists to the Kaziranga National Park. About 100 business-to-business interests have been generated during the G20 business meet at Nagaland capital Kohima. It is a high time to open international border for enhanced trade and commerce between the northeastern state and neighboring countries. This was stated by Union Minister of State for External Affairs Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh at Nagaland's capital Kohima.
Vicco Vajradanti. Shayad isme aapko taste ka maza nahi milega. Jhaag ka maza nahi milega. Ab aap sochenge to milega kya? Asar kam problems par. इसकी 18 जड़ी बूटियां स्वोलन गम्स ब्लीडिंग गम्स जैसे प्रॉब्लम्स को रखे दूर और दांतों को रखे हेल्दी. मजा नहीं, असर. अब पेस्ट है, पिक्चर का टिकट थोड़ी.
Vicco Vajradanti, इंडिया का गम एक्सपर्ट.
मजेदार नहीं, असरदार.
On April 5, the Calcutta High Court set aside the trial court order rejecting accused Raghi Parvez's application for visiting Makkah to perform Umrah during Ramzan. Live Law Report. It is to be noted that Parvez is accused in a case connected to the death of two Bangladeshi nationals who died in an accident when his Jaguar SUV smashed into a Mercedes car. The accused Parvez is on a bail and he filed an application before the trial court praying to leave the country and visit Makkah to perform Umrah during the month of Ramzan. On April 5, a man named Sadiq Khan posted a video of himself hurling abuses at the Hindu community in social media. The video went viral. Members of the BJP and other Hindu outfits gathered before the town thana and demanded strict punitive action against the accused. On April 2, Maharashtra CM Eknath Shinde led the ruling BJP Shiv Sena Savarkar Gaurav Yatra in Thane. The Yatra comes amid the efforts by the ruling coalition to play up the Congress leader Rahul Gandhi's comment on Veer Savarkar following his disqualification from the Lok Sabha. Rahul was disqualified as an MP after being convicted in the criminal defamation case over a remark using the surname Modi on March 25. He had said that my name is not Savarkar, my name is Gandhi. Gandhi has not apologized to anyone. The constitution will perish if India's demography is altered. Indian tradition and Dharma project it, says Madras High Court judge. If the demographic profile is altered, the constitution ceases to exist. So if the constitution has to be there forever means the demographic profile should also remain the same. If that is to happen, people who follow the Indian tradition and the Indian Dharma should remain in the same tradition. Union Ministry of Home Affairs has recommended a CBI probe against Oxfam India for alleged violation of Foreign Contribution Regulation Act 2010. Oxfam India was registered under the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act 2010 for undertaking social activities and its registration certificate was valid up to December 31, 2021. Bhubaneswar, Odisha, due to decreasing thunderstorm activities, there is a slight rise in the temperature in the last 2 to 3 days. Yesterday, Jharsuguda has recorded the highest temperature of 38.5 degrees Celsius. Dr. H.R. Biswas, Director, IMD Bhubaneswar, said. Shatrujit Brigade of Indian Army participated in a major multi-domain exercise with Tri-Services Andaman and Nicobar Command to rehearse its rapid reaction capabilities on the strategically located Andaman and Nicobar Island. Union Minister Piyush Goyal says that Congress has made up its mind from the beginning that they would not allow the House to function against a budget which was accepted by every section of the country. They raised a baseless demand and interrupted the session. If any crony capitalism is happening in Congress-led government, and Rahul Gandhi will not speak a word about it, says Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman as she hits out at Congress leader Rahul Gandhi. The opposition had never imagined that Article 370 would be a history one day. They cannot digest the works BJP is doing. Today, they have become so desperate that they have openly started saying, "Modi, teri kabar khudegi," said PM Modi on the foundation day of BJP. We will be back with News at 9 tomorrow. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and do not forget to like and share the video and subscribe to our channel.